I'm in student mentors. So we have created this short video just to explain you how to go about your video creation process and what are the steps involved, right? So this is, I'm just doing a screen recording. I'm using QuickTime Player for this, and in the slide at the end you will also find other options with which you can do that. So let me just present it. This is how you have to just present your slide and talk and explain as you go through. So what you see over here is basically an idea to give you how to create a content. As you see, this is how your current syllabus looks like, right? There are multiple recordings that need to go through. This is what essentially you are trying to create. So basically, this is an example here. The course is ME2260, which contains 9 major topics. So I have just tried to kind of very high level divide it into multiple sections. You see this 2 lectures plus 4 lectures, across like 6 lectures here. This is another 6 lectures, so I've marked it as section 2. This is 5 lectures, so section 3, and so on. You can decide how you want to distribute it. But the idea is that you have to try and cover the entire course in 1 hour. Now in this example, the number of sections are 7. So the video time per section is going to be 9 minutes, right? 60 minutes divided by 7. Now I understand in some cases, certain sections might be very complicated. Like for example, I see here that the failure of materials is 9 lectures. So in that case, if you want to take little bit more time for that and reduce time from some other section, that is okay too. So you can do a slight up and down in the number of minutes, but try and make sure that the overall summary is around 1 hour. Now getting into how do you create slides for the PPT, right? So this is an example of the number of slides that I have prepared. I think I've prepared maximum 5 or 6. So you again have to create similar short and concise slides that you have to share when you are presenting. Try to add any examples, or if let's say in class sir has tried to solve some question, you can add that, any image if you feel that makes the concept help explain better. You can add an image or any GIF of how things work, and with an arrow and comments like this, you can explain what is going on there. Now, to record a video, as I told in the beginning, you can use your default recorder that you have in your laptop. If you are using Windows laptop, there is something called as Xbox Game Bar. You can just search for it. Mostly all the Windows 7 and above have this default inbuilt. So you can just open that and start capturing. Make sure that it is capturing your audio as well, so that as you explain, it gets captured too. So you can start recording and start explaining and going through the slide. Once you are done for a particular section, make sure that you record it. Similarly, if you are using a Mac, you can use a QuickTime Player. Here you can just go to the file that is something called as new screen recording. Again, make sure that your microphone is connected and it's capturing that as well. You can start recording, and after it's done, you can save that particular file. Now, what if for some reason none of the default recorders in your laptop are working? In that case, what you can do, a quick hack, is basically use Zoom. So you just create a meeting on your own, just you connected in it. You can start recording, and you can explain and go through your PPTs as you are explaining to your friend. Once you are done with a particular section and you feel that this can be now recorded, you just end the meeting. Only when you end the meeting in Zoom is basically when the recording happens. So it will show you a recorded video. Make sure that you save that video after the meeting is ended. Now that you have understood how the recording process works, the first thing is to do is to send a test video. So for that, we are not asking you to create a long video. You can just create like a 2-minute video with the process that we have mentioned here on any topic, not even essentially about the course that you have selected to do a summary for in the form. You can choose any topic, just to do a 2-minute video. All we want to see is basically how you explain. If there are any suggestions from our side, we will share that with you, just to make sure that the video comes out better. you can tag that video with a particular convention that is mentioned here, which is your name, roll number, test gramming. So that way we can distinguish between the different videos that we receive. And this you can share through Google Drive to this email ID. Yeah, we'll be sharing on the message the date by which we expect you guys to share the video. So yeah, let's get started.